is somebody who is really at the tip of the spear when it comes to credibly challenging this fable. Richard, thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Alex. It's again my honor to be here with you.
Well, you've got the floor. Tell us about the latest developments, where Architects and Engineers is right now, what these truth hearings are, and where you think 9/11 truth is going 10 years on.
Well, there, as you mentioned, I'm representing 1,500 architects and engineers, now 1,560 actually. And these are demanding a real investigation of the destruction of the three center high-rises on 9/11. And the people in the street understand that Building 7 is a demolition. And I want to tell you also that every architect and engineer that I talk to, almost without exception, really, when they see Building 7, they agree it is a controlled demolition. And then they're just shocked. Their jaws are open. They're receptive to hearing the evidence about the Twin Towers, which, of course, unfortunately, is replete with evidence, science-based forensic evidence, documenting its controlled demolition. So I've traveled all around the world now in 23 different countries, speaking to groups of 100 to 700. And we're in Toronto, gathered by a group of very distinguished 9/11 researchers who have brought a distinguished panel of academicians to hear the evidence over a four-day period, where we are bringing A to Z, you know, everything that has happened at on 9/11 and around 9/11, for me particularly, testifying as to the explosive demolition of these three high-rises. This will be available in documented form, written and in film, and this will be presented to the governments of the Canada and the United States. And so we're all proud to be here together in one consolidated, a very academic atmosphere, presenting this information. So I'm looking forward to making sure that you get the DVD, Alex. And we have put out a new film, also called 9/11 Experts Speak Out, a 9/11 Explosive Evidence Experts Speak Out. So AE 9/11 Truth has assembled 43 of our top petition signers, experts in their field in we're talking about high-rise architects, metallurgists, chemists, physicists, structural engineers, assembled technical and building professionals, tops in their field, for a new film that we have put together that lays out these elements, not from, you know, Richard Gage in seeming isolation, but really top people. And it's extraordinary. We had our premiere the other night here in Toronto, and it went very well. And this is the pre-release edition. So I encourage people to take a look at it, give us feedback for our final edition at ae911truth.org. We're very excited about that, as well as the video that you mentioned, Alex, the documentary on World Trade Center 7 with Ed Asner. It has reached 270,000 views in just 3 or 4 weeks. We're very excited about that as well, because it presents the evidence for World Trade Center 7 as much as you can fit in a very melodramatic way. In other words, attention getting, in just 15 minutes. So,
well, Richard,
I'm encouraging you to take a look.
Richard, again, this is a big deal. We went out on the streets of Austin and went up to 15 people randomly, saying, who will talk to us, and showed them video of Building 7 falling, and all but one said, looks like a controlled demolition. And that's the same feedback I get from everybody, but that's not just the falling of 7. I'm going to go out next week and show people the Building 7 and then show the police on CNN saying, get back, we're going to bring that building down, it's coming down, and Larry Silverstein, the owner, saying it. You start adding all that and the blast points, the squibs, all of it. I mean, this is the greatest hoax in history. Is the hoax coming down? Because on the street, on radio, on foreign radio, all I get is people waking up. firefighters, police. They're not even invited as first responders because the government knows that they're angry and know the truth. We've confirmed that from the 9/11 ceremonies coming up Sunday. And so what I want you in closing to speak about is your view. From my perspective, but you travel all over the world, the awakening's bigger than ever. But there's this new talking point by Slate, BBC, New York Times, just scores of publications that 9/11 truth is dead, nobody cares, we're discredited with no evidence. So they're basically trying to sell this hoax idea, kind of like the idea that Ron Paul can't win when he's winning all the big polls, that, oh, you guys have been discredited when the opposite is happening.
Yeah, that's my experience as well, Alex. It can be a little disheartening to hear those comments. You know, it's like watching a swimming pool fill up. The level, in the 5 years, there's been a lot of rise in the level of responsiveness in the street to the activists, and I'm out there with them in the street fairly often. And 5 years ago, it was, you know, you get the middle finger and so forth, and conspiracy theorists. Now, largely, most people are fairly receptive. It is extraordinary. So we're gauging the level of unconscious, and it is not dead whatsoever. We're very excited about what's happening here. The level of support that we have in our organization in order to make a film like the one we're talking about and produce it and get it out there, it takes a lot of support, and we're getting that support. There's no loss here. There's only gain. We're brought all around the world. This week in Toronto, we're going to New York. Next week, we have a debate with the physicist Dave Thomas and Dr. Mueller from UC Berkeley. This is going to be broadcast on every Pacifica station across the country. Well, there's five of them, but then 100 affiliates as well on September 11th, 7 p.m. Eastern time. And during that, believe it or not, our premiere of this new movie, 9/11 Explosive Evidence, Experts Speak Out, is playing in New York at Old Souls Church in New York on September 11th at 7 p.m. And then we also have the Liberty Fest, which is an extraordinary We Are Change New York event that has already pre-sold 400 tickets. So I'll be speaking there.
So just another example of the fact that you're constantly touring around the country and the world, getting a huge response. And again, as a syndicated radio host, I can tell you 9/11 truth is only growing faster. Overall liberty is only intensifying. Now, getting into some of the issues here in closing, Richard, obviously there's the Building What campaign in New York that's exposing Building 7. That's getting huge attention. Do you agree that out of all the smoking guns, the biggest one is Building 7?
Yeah, you know why, Alex? Because a child can look at that building and know that it's being blown up. You can tell that child, do you know our government told us that a few small fires, well, they call them big, brought this building down? Nobody believes that. When people understand that we've been lied to and manipulated by NIST, it took them 7 years to ultimately come out with this set of lies, while acknowledging that the building fell as fast as a bowling ball falling off the side of it, straight down, uniformly, almost into its own footprint, free fall acceleration for a third of its 6-second fall. This is absolutely extraordinary, and so it's a hands-down win. I mean, my job is easy, and I know you have similar sets of experiences with the range of issues that you expose. It's not difficult to tell the truth. They've got the hard job. They've got the uphill climb. We are coasting on the truth, and I am so glad to be alongside you in this info war.
Well, Richard, God bless you and your hard work. In closing, I would just throw a story at you. I talked to a firefighter student who's going to firefighting school, and they told him there's been changes to the manuals now. Before, they said steel started weakening at about 2,200, 2,500 degrees, depending on the type of steel, and it started melting, depending on the type, at 3,000 or more. But they said now that they're changing things, 1,000 degrees, they're saying, will weaken and make a building fall in. So they're having to change insurance actuaries. The false science, false physics that the government has gone along with is changing reality, but only in fantasy land. We've seen countless big skyscraper fires in the 10 years since 9/11. None of them ever collapse. Still, it wouldn't be symmetrical. I mean, this is totally and utterly ridiculous. Your comment on that?
Yeah, absolutely correct, Alex. We had not lost one skyscraper from much hotter, much larger, and longer-lasting fires. And yet NIST didn't even examine the only other possibility for how these buildings are destroyed, and that is have been destroyed. It should have been the first, if not the only, hypothesis they looked at, but they didn't even examine it. It is a complete cover-up. Nor did they examine or acknowledge the pools of molten iron seen by the first responders, the structural engineers, the iron workers in the basements of the Twin Towers and the debris pile of Building 7, or these iron-rich microspheres, molten iron microspheres found in all the World Trade Center dust samples by the USGS. Not by conspiracy theorists. This is documented by the USGS, as is
Or the BBC reporting Building 7 had fallen because of fires in its own footprint 25 minutes before it happened, and later admitting Reuters gave them a script. They jumped the gun on that. Or the police saying, get back, we've been told they're going to blow it up. I've talked to the officers, not just watch the news cams. And then the pro-official story people say, oh, you're saying cops blew it up. No, cops were compartmentalized, told, we're blowing it up, get back. So the cops were like, all right, they're blowing it up, get back. And I remember that day on the news, on the radio, they said, we're looking at blowing up Building 7 to protect other buildings. Then they blew it up and said, we didn't blow it up. Richard Gage, God bless you, and thank you for joining us. And I know that a couple more anniversaries coming up here that we are going to be able to clearly show that 9/11 truth has certainly, at least in the court of public opinion, exposed the true perpetrators. Thank you so much, sir.
That's right, Alex. I'm with you on that one. Thank you so much.
Bye-bye. Thank you. Thank you, Richard. All right. That's it for this special pre-9/11 10th anniversary edition. We appreciate Richard Gage joining us. The rest of the crew doing a great job this week. I'll be back on the radio live this Sunday, 4 to 6 p.m., and then back Monday, 11 a.m., and back here Monday, 7 p.m. for InfoWars Nightly News. Richard's Skype was a bit choppy, but the information cut through, and that's what's important. Please, if you're not a subscriber to PrisonPlanet.tv, support alternative media. Go to InfoWarsNews.com and check out the special reports section, the nightly news section, the daily radio / TV section, my rants section at InfoWarsNews.com or PrisonPlanet.tv. And if you are a subscriber, think about purchasing another subscription and to give it to your friends and family, because then you share the gift of information and awakening, but you also support our growing operation. We couldn't have done any of this without you. And as the French philosopher said, Victor Hugo, no army can stop an idea whose time has come. Or as V for Vendetta says, ideas are bulletproof. Be safe. Have a great weekend. And we will see you again back here 7 p.m. next Monday. I'm Alex Jones, signing off from the front lines of the InfoWar. God bless you all.